In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of hip ligaments. In first part, I am going to explain basic anatomy of ligaments. On second part, I am going to explain relationship with muscles. Hip joint is here. There are three ligaments around hip joint. This one is kind of the widest ligament, kind of biggest ligament. This is iliofemoral ligament. Iliofemoral ligament, because this ligament connects ilium and femur. Iliofemoral ligament. That makes sense. Okay? Iliofemoral ligament. Next one is this one. This is pubofemoral ligament. Pubofemoral ligament, because that connects pubis and femur. Pubofemoral ligament. That's easy to remember. Oh, by the way, what is this one? This is not ligament. This is part of joint. This is bursa. You see bursa here and here. Bursa is like lubrication system in joint. Bursa kind of decreases friction, so you can move joint freely with less stress. Then let's go to backside of hip joint. Okay, this is backside. By the way, this is iliofemoral ligament. The last ligament is this one. This is also big ligament. This one connects ischium and femur. You can suggest name of this ligament. This is ischiofemoral ligament. Ischiofemoral ligament. So there are three ligaments. Iliofemoral ligament. Right here. Iliofemoral. This is pubofemoral ligament. Then the last one is ischiofemoral ligament. This is basic anatomy of hip ligament. So let's go to relationship with muscles. I want to talk about relationship with pubofemoral ligament and this muscle. This is obturator externus. Obturator externus. This is part of deep lateral rotator. In this picture, this muscle is a little bit narrower than usual. That's what you see in anatomy books. Usually, obturator externus is a little bit wider. It's like this. Then, obturator internus and pubofemoral ligament are very close each other. So, if obturator externus gets tight, maybe this tension can create tension of pubofemoral ligament. Vice versa, if your pubofemoral ligament gets tight, maybe your obturator externus gets tight. What is problem with that? What is main function of ligament in general? Function of ligament is to stabilize joint in adequate position, right? If you got torn ligament, your joint is out of place, right? If your ligament gets too tight, maybe your range of motion decreases. That is problem. Again, if your obturator externus gets tight, maybe there can be tension around pubofemoral ligament. Vice versa, if your pubofemoral ligament is tight, obturator externus can get tight. This muscle is very important for hip movement and hip stability. So, no wonder if one of these tissues gets tight, that creates tightness of hip joint. This is relationship with pubofemoral ligament and obturator externus. Let's go to next connection. We have many muscles. I want to focus on three muscles. This is rectus femoris. The rectus femoris. This one is vastus lateralis. And this one is gluteus minimus. So, like obturator externus, these three muscles have relationship with hip ligaments or hip connective tissue. Let's start with gluteus minimus first. Insertion of gluteus minimus is very close to hip ligaments. So if you follow myofascial connection, connective tissue connection, you can reach to hip ligaments. I don't say this muscle attaches to ligament, but there is connective tissue connection. You can follow connection to ligament. So when this muscle gets tight, that can inhibit hip joint movement. That makes sense. Next one, vastus lateralis. Its origin is kind of a greater trochanter. This muscle also doesn't attach to ligament. However, there is myofascial connection, connective tissue connection. So when vastus lateralis gets tight, this can also inhibit movement of hip joint. Then last one, this is rectus femoris, right? Origin of rectus femoris is about here. This part is AIIS, anterior inferior iliac spine. However, there is one more attachment that is here. So there are two fibers, superior one and inferior one. This inferior part attaches to edge of acetabulum. Acetabulum is like a socket part of pelvis. Imagine acetabulum is like this and head of femur fits like that. This part is acetabulum. Rectus femoris attaches to kind of edge of acetabulum. That's very interesting. This part is close to acetabulum. That said, this part is close to joint. What are they? They are ligaments. Again, when this part gets tight, that may affect for tension of ligament. That can affect movement of hip joint. Thus, gluteus minimus, vastus lateralis, and rectus femoris are important for hip movement. Of course, other muscles are equally important, like hamstrings are important for movement, adductor muscles are important, gluteus maximus is important, but today's topic is relationship with hip connective tissue, hip ligaments. In terms of relationship of hip ligaments, these three muscles are important. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of hip ligaments and I explained relationship with muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.